Hi, welcome to Hope in the Light of Suicide. I'm Tammy White. I'm your host here and founder and CEO of the Bobby White Foundation. I'm a little hyped up today because we've got a lot going on. Getting ready for Art for Hope coming up and just getting off my, got off my birthday weekend and anniversary and last week, and that all went well. The heaviness of the blue moon lightened up just in time, and it was a good day. I went, what did I do? Oh, I went and got a massage and a cranial release treatment. I tell you what, this is something that everybody should do. It is so good. A massage and a CRT treatment. It does wonders for your psyche and your body and all. That was one of my birthday gifts to myself. And Saturday, my little neighbor Amber and I went out shopping. We went to some really cool, kind of, Bobby would call them hippy dippy type stores, and picked up some plants and stuff, and went out to lunch at this little cute little. It's a restaurant bar. It's more of a bar, but it's like a old Florida type thing on the water. And their food, they have a food truck there, and I think it moved. I heard them like talking about it a little bit, but anyway, the foods are really good. So we went and did that, and we were gonna go do some more shopping at the Sponge Docks. And the plants that we picked up when we got back into the car after having lunch were kind of starting to wilt a little bit. So we were like, I think we need to get these plants back home. And so we just ended up coming back home. But we got home just in time because then it started raining. So all our new plants got some fresh water. So it ended up being a good weekend, and some friends kind of extended it for me with calls and stuff. And my brother called, and that's always nice to hear from him, especially because our mom used to call all of us kids to remind each of us whose birthday it was and to call. And since she passed away, she's not out there to remind him, and he did good. So I really appreciate the call from my brother Troy. So with all this other stuff going on, of course, we're getting ready for Art for Hope. We had our final volunteer meeting, getting things in line. We just have a few little things to work out for the event. But I want to, you know, thank Area 52 Media Group being our major sponsor and my producer and sponsor here for the show. And also the Rotary Club of the Nature Coast and Precision Survey and Mapping. Everybody's support is just so much appreciated. And then, of course, we've got Leanne's Old Fashioned Cookies is going to be there. Everybody loves her cookies. And I think she even said, and she does this every year, and I kind of forget, but she's going to be raffling off a box or two of her delicious cookies. And, you know, I mean, if you have a business or even just for friends and family, she does ship all over the United States. And her packaging is phenomenal. So that's really good. And so anyway, the reason I'm kind of like a little wired, of course, you're going to see this a few days later, but I ran down this morning to pick up some artwork that was being donated to Art for Hope. I want to thank Attorney Deborah Diaz. She donated some artwork. So we went and pick some of that up this morning, get that ready for the event. And, you know, the event's held at the Hilton Garden Inn. And this piece of art that we're going to show you, that's one of the pieces that's available, is called Gulf Gypsy. And it's by an artist that I have represented for years. I mean, I think I started representing him like 25 years ago. This piece is actually hanging at the Hilton Garden Inn, along with a collection of his artwork. Neil Adamson, He passed away last year. I think it was last year. Might have been 2 years because time flies. But he is an excellent artist, has won numerous awards nationally and internationally. He's got, I think there's still a couple of his paintings hanging at an embassy in South Africa. And it was so sad when he passed away. It was just prior to one of our events. But anyway, so we have a collection of his artwork. He was actually a retired St. Petersburg, Florida firefighter. But his work is really good. But when we sell his work, that's going to be the last of it that we have. I have a piece that I'm keeping for myself, but yeah, we won't be able to get any more of his pieces, or they won't be available. So anyway, so be sure that even if you're in the area, if you go to the Hilton Garden Inn, just walk the main floor lobby area, back in the bar area towards the conference rooms. Actually, three of our artists' works are there, so they'll all be available at Art for Hope. So why do we do all this stuff? Why do we raise this money? Well, it is so that we can bring programs like this even to our community. We were fortunate enough to this year finally be able to start a couple of support groups. So we have a support group in West Pasco in Newport Richey that is the third Thursday of the month. And then we have the one in Spring Hill in Hernando County that is the second Wednesday of the month. This one we partnered with NAMI Hernando for the space. They've been really great, great for us. So put these on your calendar. I did put an event for each of these on the foundation Facebook page, and I think on the show Facebook page too. If I didn't, I'm going to go back and double check just to make sure that I did. so everybody knows when they're going to be happening. So hopefully, I'm keeping my fingers crossed. I haven't heard any news yet about it, but we're trying to partner with Pasco County Parks and Recreation for space on the east side of the county to start a group over there. And so hopefully that's going to be happening in October. It would be nice. I have spoken to a couple of people that are interested in participating in that because it's just too far to come to the west coast of Pasco or the west side of Hernando to the groups. But we're getting there. Our goals are slowly being achieved. So so that's good. So another thing, and I mentioned this last week, and I'm going to start rolling it out probably by the time the show airs, is our partnership with SAMHSA for their first ever, and it all coincides with Art for Hope and everything, and National Suicide Prevention Week, is the first annual 988 Day. So, and the theme for 988 is, I can't even read it, something. No worries, just help. You know, just no judgment, just help. My timer's in my way, and I have to. No judgment, just help. And I'm gonna be putting out some yard signs. And actually, I was at a fundraiser last week for the foundation. A group that we have lunch, Reuters. They do a fundraiser a couple times a year for the foundation, and so it's. With it just being just before Art for Hope and my birthday and our anniversary, they did a second one. So a couple there, they're going to be taking a couple of these yard signs and putting them out in front of their business. So this is going to be an annual event thing. So this is the theme this year, no judgment, just help. We'll be putting out a bunch of stuff on social media. And it falls on a Sunday. We've got a lot of really great social media tools that SAMHSA has allowed us to use. So we're excited about that, just so we can, you know, get the information out more. And that coincides a little bit with, you know, I go out and I speak to business clubs, organizations, and we do it here at the end of every show. Is we show the lifeline numbers. So I was in Tampa and at the Center Club business luncheon, and I want to thank John, my producer. He attended and was supportive. So here's a friend sent this picture to me of me asking everybody there to take out their phones and put these numbers in their phones. And everybody either took out their phones, put their numbers in the phone, or took a picture of it. And that always it's always a good thing. But I do that every single time. I just thought it was kind of cool that she got a picture of me doing that and pointing, do this. So, and we do it at the end of every show too. So, it's just kind of neat. I'm hoping to get some other pictures from the event. I was really pleased that the presentation went very, very well. I felt John said it went good too. So I trust his judgment. And people came specifically to the luncheon to listen to me talk. And the feedback and the discussion, even afterwards or Q&A, was really good. You know, and that's what we got to do, is just, you know, it's the education and getting people, you know, to understand and look for signs and ways that they can help. And it's kind of simple ways and simple things, but if you don't know what it is, then you don't know, and you don't know how you can help people. And people really come away with this with a little bit more I guess confidence, a little bit, you know. But I was having a discussion with one of the guys there, super nice guy I met several months ago when I started going to the Center Club. And he had related to me a situation that he went through. And, you know, sometimes the signs just aren't there. Maybe in hindsight, but it's so, sometimes it could be so vague. But, you know, sometimes we can, you know, even if we know what to look for, sometimes it's just not there. If a person is intent on taking their life, sometimes it's just, they can hide it, and they can hide it very well. And this was one of those situations where that happened, and it's really hard on the survivors left behind, because, you know, you try so hard to, and you think, you know, what did I miss? And again, sometimes you didn't miss anything. They just were really good at getting ready for what they were inevitably gonna do. And it is. I mean, it's hard, but that's where you got to do, you know, a lot of self-care. We talked about that a little bit, and I forgot to get her business card out of my file folder. I'm going to be meeting up with a gal who, and don't even remember her name. I'm really bad at that if I don't have that, especially when I first meet someone. I was supposed, was semi-self-introduced or was told, okay, you need to talk to this gal. So she actually was at the luncheon, and she works with veterans, and it's for prevention, but it's for pre-prevention. Not just prevention. It's before you have to get to the prevention part. And this was something that I wasn't familiar with. And we were able to talk a little bit, and we're going to have her here on the show pretty soon. Probably, well, at least before, probably right after Art for Hope, we'll have her on the show. And, you know, before November, when Veterans Day is and stuff. So that's going to be really interesting. I think it's going to be a great, great community partner for us to add to some of our information, and, you know, somebody to work with, you know, on another level, which is really great. She also is a veteran. And so she comes, you know, a little bit from that world. So working a lot of times working with veterans, that makes it easier also, because you know and you understand that world and what they're going through, you know, especially with coming out of the service and transitioning into a totally different life. We had a guest on not long ago. Oh man, Alvin. He started a nonprofit for veterans, and he just had the anniversary of his first year of transitioning out of the service, and it wasn't an easy one for him or his family, but you know, he continues to work through it. He uses his experience to help other veterans. Is it Stairway for Veterans? Something like that. Anyways, he's like I said, he just celebrated his first year, and it's hard. I met with a young gal. I don't know if I mentioned it last week or not. She's gonna be attending our support group, but she wanted to meet with me first and talk with me, and it's a really sweet young gal, and her younger brother was only 22 years old, took his life, was in the service, or just coming out of the service. This was a couple years ago. And, you know, we've been told with some of the research and statistics, you know, you always hear it, 22 veterans a day take their life, 22 a day. Well, with a lot of the work that is being done, that is one demographic, thankfully, that we're beginning to get a teeny bit of a grasp on. It's been dropping you hear conflicting numbers, but about 18 to 20. So, I mean, even just one is a lot. It's not enough. It's a lot. It's a lot, but we need to do more for all demographics. But 18 to 20, hopefully only, but that's, one is way too, way, way, way too many. And, you know, in my presentation, I gave them some statistics about the Tampa Bay area. And the four counties, Pinellas, Hillsborough, Pasco, and Hernando. Pasco and Hernando statistically ranks higher in suicide death rates than the Florida numbers of the whole state in all age demographics except for I think it was the numbers 10 to 17. And in those demographics, the 10 to 17, it switched up a bit that Hernando County and Pinellas County were statistically higher than the state numbers, which is scary. Hernando, even though they have a lesser population, statistically with their numbers, it's higher all across the board. So I think it was interesting for people to see some of what these numbers were, because it's not something that people usually know or talk about. But you know, I did it more county by county the Bay Area, because being in Hillsborough, which is probably our biggest county including in the Bay Area. But anyways, and also part of that was added that we have 11 a suicide in the United States every 11 minutes. Every 11 minutes. I think in 2022, we had over 49,000 suicides in the United States. And it blows your mind. I think Pasco County in 2022, we had 119. In 2016, when we lost Bobby to suicide, we had 104. And I think in those years between 2016 and 2022, which is the most recent numbers that we have, one year the rate might have been lower than 2016, but every other year was just up. It just goes up, just like the national rate. You know, I've mentioned before, since they've been tracking all this, the suicide rate, the line looks like this, just every year up, up, up. But so that's why we and some of the people that I met at the business lunch and the organizations that we partner with, Zero Suicide Partners of Pinellas County, Zero Suicide Partners of Hillsborough County, Pasco's Zero Suicide Program is safe. Actually, I think I have a meeting today. We have a safe meeting. So it takes a village. It takes all of us. Not a one of our organizations is going to be able to tackle this. But that's where also Art for Hope comes in, because we get to educate other people. It's it's an uplifting event. It's free to attend. We have free orders, light orders. It is a cash bar, but we're in the process of getting all the artwork in order. Hopefully we'll get to go down a little bit early and start getting things prepared. So there's going to be a whole lot out on social media. I have been adding the some of the artwork available on our social media pages. So be sure you can go to the Art for Hope Facebook page, the Bobby White Foundation Facebook page, Tammy White Galleries Facebook page. I started with the gallery Facebook page, and then I share it with the Art for Hope Facebook page and the foundation Facebook page. So it'll be out there. So if you're in the area, please try to attend. I'm hoping that we'll get, his name is LeMay. He's this really, really cool fiddle player. He does this electric fancy fiddle thingy. He's going to come up and play the last half of the event, as he is playing at the Center Club that night. But he said he'd come up and play the last half. I hope keep fingers crossed. I'm really excited about that. So yeah, it's going to be busy. It's kind of like we're on a sprint now to to get this done. It's exciting. It's exciting every year. It falls into place every year. So there's a lot going on. So because we have now the added 988 day, it's National Suicide Prevention Week. September 10th is National Suicide Prevention Day. So it's going to be a packed next couple weeks, getting awareness out and having fun at Art for Hope, but we want to make it a light, uplifting event. And I hope you guys come out and be there. So my quote for today is a little bit heavy, but it's not. Kind of, grief is a nasty game of feeling the weakest you have ever felt and morphing into the strongest person you will have to become. And that's the way I feel totally about where I'm at. It's amazing some of the things that I think that I've done in the name of my husband. And helping our community, that's the biggest thing, is helping others. So again, be sure you put those Lifeline numbers in your phone. Have them available, even if it's a picture or in your contacts. I was really proud of everybody at the event the other day doing just that. You just never, never know. And we want to be there to help people and be kind to people and be compassionate. It is so important because it's a crazy world we're living in right now. But just remember, there is always hope. Thank you.